Hello students, welcome back to our channel. In the today's session, we are going to discuss about ionization. This ionization topic is very important. You have some idea about this ionization. If you want to learn acids and bases and any kind of reaction, if you know the ionization, the topic will become very easy. I will pretty sure that if you listen this topic carefully, by the end of this topic definitely this ionization will become very easy. See here, we'll start with the definition. Ionization is the process by which atoms or molecules get a positive or negative charge. What is the meaning of this definition? When ionization process will be done, we'll get atoms or molecules, the atoms or molecules will turn into, based on the, depends on the situation, it will get positive or negative. See, we'll see ionization. I will give one best example, general equation I will tell. For example, we are taking M substance here. When it ionizes in the aqueous solution, it dissociates into M plus plus E minus. Here one electron is removing. So what is the ion formed here? Positive ion. Positive ion is known as cation. Cation is formed here. We'll see another example. The substance, we are adding one electron here. So M negative. Negative means which ion? Anion. Anion. What is happening here in the ionization process? We are getting the ions. We are getting the ions. This is ionization process. In the ionization process, mostly ionic compounds only ionizes in the aqueous solution. Ionic, this is the important thing, note down this, ionic compounds basically form ions. Okay, ionic compounds basically form ions. We'll see one example. Tell me the common example for ionic compound, sodium chloride. So when it dissolves in the water, it dissociates into Na plus plus Cl minus. When sodium chloride dissolves in water, what will happen? It dissociates into Na plus plus Cl minus, and they conduct electricity. Ionic compounds will conduct electricity only in the presence of aqueous solution. Okay, then what about covalent compounds? Does covalent compounds undergoes ionization? Yes or no? See, the covalent compounds are two types. One is polar covalent compounds and non-polar covalent compounds. What is meant by polar covalent compounds? The polar covalent compounds, then they gives positive and negative ions. Best example for the polar covalent bond is HCl. In the polar covalent compounds, we'll see the positive and negative ions. How can the positive and negative ions in the presence in the HCl? Based on the electronegative difference between the hydrogen and chlorine. The chlorine has more electronegative than hydrogen, so the slightly positive and negative charges are formed in the presence of hydrochloric acid when it dissolves in the water. What about non-polar covalent compounds? Non-polar covalent compounds does not dissolve in the water and does not undergoes ionization. This is about ionization. Let us see some examples for the ionization process. HCl plus H2O give H3O plus H3O plus Cl minus ions. What is happening here? These are the new ions. In the case of dissociation, we cannot see any new ions, but in the presence of ionization, we can see the clearly, we can see that new ions are formed in the case of ionization. Here, when the HCl dissolves in water, the H3O plus ion is formed. H3O plus ion is formed. Let us see another example for the ionization. NH3. This is the polar covalent compound. When it dissolves in water, what is the product? NH4 plus OH minus. Here also two new ions are formed. This is about ionization. Hope this video will help you. If you like my video, please like and share with your friends and do subscribe. Thank you.